I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go, through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays.
Straight down, Earth from a bird's eye view. You should grow feathers and see this too.
Straight.
towards ground. But gravity pulls you straight down. Earth from a bird's eye view. You should grow feathers and see this too.
There you go. I bet you guys can hear me now, huh? Oh, man. Someday I'll figure this thing out. So how is everybody tonight, man? Yeah, what's... Oh, Silver's here. Sweet Dragon Lord. Dude, my mods are in the house. Hey, Samantha Hart, how you doing? Right on. Yeah, what you been up to, Silver? Ghost is here. Man, good seeing you guys. I wonder if I should let everyone know in the Discord that I'm live. All right. Yeah, so tonight I get to, I think some of you were in my stream the other day. I was talking about how I couldn't wait to show you guys the project that I've been working on for the last year and a half. Well, my company launched it, so I'm super, super stoked. So I figured I'll just, I'm going to go ahead and still get the card art started tonight. And then I'm going to, let's make it at like, let's say 10 o'clock, I'll do it. I'll do it at 10. So that gives a few people to get on here, a few more, a little more time for other people to get on here. Hey, Jeff Folio is hosting me. Thanks, bud. I appreciate that. Why am I not getting any music all of a sudden? Oh, I just I guess I had it too low. All right, never mind. Let's go back there. Just work right on. Yeah, I bet you're a busy dude, Silver. With the stuff that you do, that you work on. All right, yeah, so at 10 o'clock, I'll do show and tell, and I'll show you guys basically, I'm going to show you guys a whole bunch of stuff. Right on, Jeff. Just lurk away. No problem. Yeah, I hope you can get that fixed, man. That stinks. I guess Jeff has been having a lot of technical issues. If you guys don't know who Jeff Folio is, we've kind of partnered up a little bit, and we're trying to do kind of have a joint, not really a joint stream together all the time, but try to do things together and really just kind of promote each other's stream. So we've done some portfolio reviews, and he's going to, oh, hey, thanks for the follow, Art by Pep. He is going to the Natural History Museum on Saturday, so in 2 days from now. You're late, Chad. Nice. Yeah, it's 9:40 for me, man. If somebody's got to take off though and really wants to see it, I guess you could watch the VOD, worst case scenario. But he's going to the Natural History Museum on Saturday, and if anybody wants to join our Discord, oh yeah, Jeff just brought it up. Join our Discord there, and you can see all the information for, like, we went to the Air Museum together. He also did a zoo trip, and we just go to these different places and sketch. So anybody's welcome, no matter what level you are. It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or an expert or whatever. We just love to get to know our community and get to hang out with people that, you know, the only, like, talk to on the internet. Hey, Cross, how you doing, man? Good to see you on here. Cross is another streamer on here. Silver streams. I'm not sure who else. Oh, yeah, Prince streams. So, got a lot of streamers in here, which is really cool. But anyways, Jeff and I want to do these events and stuff like that to kind of, like, introduce us to some of the people that might be in our stream that maybe we, you know, that might be close to us at least in location. So... And then if you sign up on the Discord too, we'll make you a regular so that you can access a little bit more stuff. Uh, Let's see here. Oh, I got another follow. Hey, thanks for the follow. The Goob. Oh, did I get... Oh, Faya, thanks for the host. Faya, I appreciate that, man. Chicken, you missed the meetup. What meetup? You would have been awkward with Jeff? Oh, you mean the meetup? Ah, shoot. Yeah, I wished I could have gone to that. My boys are in football now, in flag football, and they had practice last Saturday. And I've just got a lot going on. Like, even streaming has gotten a little tougher for me. I want to start at 9, but I can't. I have to start at 9:30, but that would have been cool. I'm going to give you a follow, Goo. All right, so I'm going to get this started, and then in 15 minutes, I'll do my show and tell and kind of show you guys what I've been working on. I'm excited to show you guys because I'm pretty proud of how everything's turned out for the most part. And I'll get to show you guys some of my process, too. Things good. There we go. Oh, you know what? I was gonna get my chat on here too. Yeah, Goob. I hope I get to go to one of those meets, man. Hey, there's not an artist. How you doing tonight, man? Oh, right on. Silver's on the Discord now. Good. Yeah, I hope so, Goob. Most of the time my boys won't have practice on Saturdays. It was kind of like an early thing. Just kind of getting the boys accustomed to playing again. But a lot of times I help the coach out. It's fun. Oh, bless me. What's wrong, Jeff? Oh, I might have been echoing because I had my phone right next to the right next to my mic and I had it on. Did that help? The guy shipping the Cintiq. Uh-oh. Is it echoing anymore? Okay. Oh man, did you buy a Cintiq or something? Not an artist and you're not getting it? Searching for a longer day. People feel like the light By the way, today I actually posted something in our Discord that's under resources, and I put up there a couple of artists that I really look up to. One is Craig Mullins. I don't know, a lot of you may know who that is, but if you don't, you gotta see his work. He's like, he kind of is like the godfather of digital painting, because he was one of the first to really start doing it like seriously. And I think some of the first stuff I ever saw from him was from, if anyone remembers, this is a long, long time ago, is the game Marathon. And it was a first-person shooter on Mac. And he drew these pictures of the game that were just absolutely, I mean, they were amazing. I remember that when I saw their artwork, that I was like, wow, what is that? I didn't know who that was at the time. But anyways, I posted his stuff on the Discord today. And I did that partly because I saw an interview with Bobby Chu, where Craig Mullins, where Bobby Chu interviews Craig Mullins. And there, he's just got some really great insight that's just, most of its stuff you guys have probably heard and stuff like that, but I would say watch it all the way to the end, and he says something in the end that I think is just a really, really valuable, I don't know, I actually might talk about it tonight because I thought it was a good subject, but you mean Art God, yeah. Oh man, I hope that works out for you, Not an Artist. That stinks. Uh-oh, did you post a link? Hey, before you post any link, just ask. No problem giving it to you, Not an Artist. With Jeff and I getting attacked by those trolls, I think they mostly annoy Jeff most of the time, but just had to turn that stuff up a notch for security reasons, which stinks, but it's all good, man. Why is it not working? Just, it didn't permit him, did it? Oh, I think you posted too quick, Not an Artist. There you go. Let's see, what else did I saw something up here? Did Dragon Lore get a promotion? Oh yeah, Dragon Lore did get a promotion. She's been helping out in my chat a lot, and I was like, man, she needs to be a mod. Oh, there you go. You got the underscore. And then the other guy I posted in there, his name is Eric Timmons. Now, he might be a little less known, but he's... I love the style that he does in gouache paint. So he uses gouache and watercolor kind of mix. And it's... But I like his style a lot because it's super, super loose and super rough. He kind of, not his artwork doesn't remind me of the Feeb, but his methodology reminds me of the Feeb. Like, I just love the fact that the Feeb uses so many different tools and methods to get his outcome. And kind of Eric Timmons does the same way. And I like it. Like, I actually used some of his methods when I did those small thumbnails for the environments. I don't know if all of you saw that, but I'm gonna do some more like that for my space race stuff. Yeah, what You know what? I think, did he get timed out, guys? Would he have gotten timed out that he can't post a link now? He probably is sitting there trying to talk to us, and he can't. Seconds. Can you guys remove that, or is that not possible? Let's see, I'm gonna make the light come from that direction, so. So, I am going to talk about what Craig Mullen said at the end of his thing. I just think it's awesome, and it's really like, how do you untime out? I don't know, guys. Yeah, I thought permits let you back in too, in all honesty. Can I do anything by clicking on his name? Oh, there we go. Oh, he was banned. How was he banned? Did that work? What? Is not banned. Okay. What the heck? Is he still in here? Yeah, he's still in here. Can you talk now, not an artist? That's weird, it banned him. Oh, there he is, okay. Oh my gosh, dude. Here, not an artist, just a second, man. Why does it keep doing that? I'm sorry, not an artist. I think if you don't spell it exactly like his name, does it not allow him? I know, right, Prince? How many mods in the actual broadcaster, how many people does it take to unban someone? No, I only have one bot. I only have Nightbot open right now. That's it. Dang it. Not enough mods. This is hilarious. It should be fine now. I saw your question, by the way, Panta. Chua. I'll tell you here in a second. What's a mod wall? Oh, come on. I have to do the at symbol, huh? There, I think that should be right. Hey, Poos, how you doing tonight, man? Alright, actually, it's almost 10 o'clock. I was going to do my show until then. Man, I feel bad for Not an Artist. He's just been abused tonight. By the way, guys, Poos is one of those guys that makes you think a lot about the way you design and draw. He's got good insight. You should give him a follow too, guys, if you don't follow Poos. Anyways, I'll finish talking about... Oh, let me answer Panta's question, too. So this is a Pentel. It's a Pentel brush pen. It's all in Japanese on this version right here. But I just got it on Amazon. This is the medium, I believe. Medium pen. So it's a medium brush pen, and it comes... This comes filled with ink in here. And then comes with the brush, and then you just, like, twist that on and it pops open the ink, and then it just flows out to the nib there. Oh, okay. Oh, thanks, Poos. What's that wrench by your name for? Never seen the wrench.
That's Elaine TV. Ooh, Twitch staff.
Hey, nice meeting you, Elaine. Or Eileen. I'm sorry.
I thought that was I thought that was Poos's icon that had the wrench by it.
Twitch police. She came in because we messed up Not an Artist so bad, huh? Poor guy. But not so accurate. Man, I'm really sorry, Not an Artist. If you want, just send me the link into the... into my or you can even send it to one of the mods. Just send the link to one of them and they can post it. Oh, thanks, Eileen. Yeah, I actually go back and forth between traditional and digital quite a bit. I was actually more trained traditionally than I was digitally. So, this project right now, I really want it to be all hand done. And what I'm working on here is a card deck. And it's all going to be a hot rod themed card deck that I'm working on. And so... basically what I want to do is I want to launch this as a Kickstarter campaign, and when I do that, I want to be able to sell the artwork as part of the different tiers that you'll be able to buy into when you buy the card deck. I'll stop here and I'll show you some of the finished stuff. Elaine. Okay, I'm sorry. I'll get your name right. So are you here because of Poos? Oh yeah, Not an Artist was just posting the link to Craig Mullins. Okay. So I was getting ready to get into this deep talk about what Craig Mullins said, and I think you'll really appreciate this, Poos. He was talking about, you know, like knowing fundamentals and stuff like that. And Bobby Chu was asking him, you know, is there any advice that you can give, you know, artists and things? And one of his statements was, you know, I've seen talented people know both, you know, fundamentals and not know fundamentals. And he goes, I really think a lot of times it comes down to the idea and the feeling, you know? And I know that Poos talks about the feeling a lot of times, like you get this gut instinct, you kind of know what feels right and what looks good. And Craig Mullins was just kind of hitting that on the head, and it's definitely made me think about a lot more by hearing a few artists say that I think foundations are good, but I think foundations aren't everything, you know? That there is a certain amount of feeling and emotion and pieces that need to be put into it. Oh, thanks, Ghost. Oh, you're probably looking at, you got to be looking at Craig Mullen's stuff. Free permits, yay. Oh, you stock. Oh, okay, right on. Well, thanks for stopping by, Elaine. Yeah, Craig Mullins, he's kind of like the godfather of digital painting. I'm not sure if you've seen that. Oh, yeah, totally. I agree. 100 million to have his brain splice into mine. Hey, Zach, how you doing tonight, man? Well, I've noticed, Dragon Lord, that Craig Mullins he started doing quite a bit more traditional stuff now. So my light's coming from this way, so I'm going to end up getting a pretty good drop shadow from this pipe right here. Yeah, I was going to say, Panta, if you don't mind me calling you that, you were talking about this brush pen and being accurate. I think, you know, I don't know if it just is an issue where it just need a little more practice or something like that, but I will say that when I first started doing this, I didn't have as much control over it as I do now. All right, so it's 10:06. I said I was going to do a show and tell now. I want to show you guys a project that I've been working on for like a year and a half. Oh, you know what? No, I was going to finish. I was going to tell you. I'm getting totally sidetracked. I got like 1,000 things running through my head right now. Elaine, so anyways, back to this. I, you know, anybody that's in my stream that hasn't seen this before, what I'm working on is it's a card deck, and I'm going to launch it hopefully next month on Kickstarter. And it's a and I've redone all the face cards. Right now, like, what you're looking at is the Ace of Diamonds. And if you look right below my video, I actually laid out a quick comp of what the Jack of Clubs looks like. So all the face cards are cars. So all the kings are trucks. All the queens are late 40s to early 50s cars. And then the jacks are what they call gassers, which are kind of like an early funny car style of car that's pretty wild looking. So I've redone all of these cards, and each one is getting a new custom artwork on it. But they're all hand done. So real quickly, I'll show you guys that haven't seen this, some of the finished product. Something going on after the stream? Not that I plan on. Yeah, let me show you guys some of the finished stuff. So this one here is the the Ace of Diamonds. Let me turn this off too. I need to let a lot of this dry anyway, so I'm gonna put that up there. So this is the Ace of Spades. And then let me grab the rest of the stuff. So this here is the backs. So this design is going to get flipped and rotated and put into place, and I needed this to be absolutely symmetrical because it's the back of the cards, and you don't want any kind of imperfection to show that, to signify different cards or anything like that. So you needed this to be perfect. So I'm gonna flip all this stuff in Photoshop, and then this is the Ace of Hearts. And this one I just finished recently. This is the Ace of Clubs. And then this is the Jack of Spades. This is a 41 Willys. This is a gasser car right here that I was talking about. That's like right below my video. And so basically how these cars are made, they're actually lifted up off the air, and they're actually slightly tilted towards the back. And somehow I think the original thought that I read about these cars is they said that they wanted the car lifted in the air and all the torque was supposed to kind of go back into the wheels since the car was lifted. I don't know, it was something odd. So anyways, that's the jacks, and they're all gonna be gassers like this, kind of jacked up in the air is the idea behind it. And then this is the middle piece that's going on right here, like you see below my video, the in-between piece. So all the face cards will get an in-between piece like this, but this will be consistent across this will be on all the jacks, and then the king will get one and the queen will get one. And then the jokers are going to be funny cars, like old nostalgic 1960s funny cars. So, and here's actually originally, this is what I had intended. I was going to do it all in pencil drawings and then moved into the inking because I felt like when it was reduced, it looked a lot nicer in the inks. So, Okay, sounds good, Jeff. Not an artist. Can I talk about Craig Mullins some more? Sure. I'm actually going to do show and tell here, too, next. Still liking that Willie. Thanks, Dragon Lord. What else we got here? What am I missing? Anything? Show and tell, vroom vroom, poos. I like that burning car poos, that's funny. Play the song? What's the song, Heatnix? No, not an artist, behave yourself. That's funny. Anyways, that's the gist of the card deck so far. The next big part of that I have to do is get the deck box done. So, what was it, not an artist, that you wanted to know about Craig Mullins? I mean, basically his history is that if you go to our Discord, mine and Jess Folio's Discord, I posted a video on there on resources, and Bobby Chu from Schoolism did a great interview with him, and he kind of tells his past and like his present and like what he's doing now and stuff like that. Oh, the song Ace of I Gotcha by Motorhead. Yeah, he's an amazing artist. He did say that he started out like when he was 15 years old at like digital painting, and he was doing it with a mouse. And then later on, he did get like this weird digital pen that he talked about. If you go to our Discord, here, not an artist, I'll type it in. Oops. Oh yeah, there you go. So if you go in there and you look under our resources tab, I posted some stuff about Eric Timmons and also Craig Mullins. And you can check that out in there. It's pretty sweet. But earlier I was saying that he brought up some stuff about, you know, if you're not totally disciplined in your foundations, that it doesn't make you a bad artist, but you know, you can have, and then you can also have somebody that knows their foundations really well, but they almost know it so well that it becomes so disciplined that they lose character and artistic value to their work, because it dries it out, I guess you could say. So, anyways, I'm going to show you guys basically what I've been working on for the last year and a half. And so some of you know that I'm a full-time designer for a company called Fly Racing. So my main job there is designing helmets. And so I design a bunch of stuff for the motocross industry. And so this is a helmet that I've been working on for the last year and a half, and it just came out. They just launched it, and I was just in Taiwan, and I brought this back with me from Taiwan. But I wanted you guys to see it, so here it is. Now, I don't know how good this is going to show up. I might have to go to my desktop to show it off, like the digital pictures. But it's so what I did is I actually styled the whole helmet, and then I also did the graphics on this one too. And believe it or not, these graphics were inspired by I was like heavy into Destiny, and the SRL, which was called Sparrow Racing League, inspired these graphics a lot. So, anyways, this is what I've been working on. Came out pretty sweet. It's like this, you can't really see it in the black, but this has a really cool pattern in it. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. So anyways, this thing took a year and a half to develop. It's like, it's gotta be like certified to protect somebody's head, basically, if they take a crash in it. So you learn a lot of those mechanics just, you know, being in the industry. And I'll show you kind of how it originally started. Let me see, I'm missing some stuff here. Let's see. Yeah, Cross, you're right. They become good and they lose a lot of their energy. That's true too. Oh, you did autocross. Oh, that's cool. Well, I agree, but when Jeff spoke about perspective, I spent the day relearning it, and it helped with distance's viewpoint and how I can improve illusions. Yeah, that's true, not an artist. But I think, I know one thing, if you watch Poos's stream, he talks about, like, you know, using scale and stuff like that to really create those things too. I'm not saying that one way is right or wrong. I just like to hear the different theories and what people say. I will say, you know, I mean, perspective is ingrained in my head, and now when I draw stuff, I know how to fix something because I do know perspective. You know, and somebody that might be early on, kind of, you know, amateur, just learning stuff, they might draw something, but they don't know how to fix it, you know? And they know it's wrong, so. Oh, did you see the mouthpiece, Dragon Lord? Who's going to use it? Hopefully somebody on a motorcycle. You can't really see that very well. I wonder if I can get a better shot of it under here. There we go. There it is. There, now you can see the pattern in it. So anyways, how this helmet ends up is, so originally I do a bunch of drawings, like you guys, you know, have seen me do with my concept art and stuff. And I probably did like, oh my gosh, 20 different versions of this, to be honest with you. Let me, I'll bring up some stuff and I'll kind of show you guys, I'll take you a little bit through the process. Oh my gosh, I have so many ideas. I should have loaded this up earlier, but oh well. So I'm not even going to show you guys everything that I ever worked on this thing, because it's like countless and countless of drawings. But this shows kind of what I've talked about in the past about concepting stuff from the beginning and really going through like a lot of iterations to get to a final design. And I see that like when a lot of people are working on their portfolios and stuff, as a designer, like when we're interviewing people, this is stuff we look for, you know, like to see all this ideation. All right, let me switch over to my desktop here. So some of these are like really loose to really rough. I actually used a helmet as a base. And these may not be in any certain order, but you can see where I, you know, these early ones, I'm just playing with new surfaces and new looks. This was like, I did like, I don't know how many visor sketches of just trying to find a good design for the visor. And I'll be the first to admit, sometimes I draw ugly stuff and, you know, I'll keep progressing and trying to get something that's new and fresh. So like some of these, like some of the issues that I didn't like, and I have a design director too that we work with, and we work really close together. And so we just went back and forth a lot, and we felt like some of these were too busy, kind of like for the market now. So I started working out more that were a few more that were a little more simple. I was starting to eliminate these long lines on here, trying some new style events. These were playing with like new mouth pieces, the way they would fit in there, which actually this is the one that ended up kind of being the final one, which ended up being this here, because this the nose right here cuts out. Like this is actually part of the helmet, and then the mouthpiece continues over here, which is kind of a unique design feature. I'll start closing some of these down too. So. This ended up being, I did several iterations of these. Like I started kind of finalizing some of the final looks of this stuff. So like, you know, I really like the vent back here, and this was kind of a cool design feature back here. You know, some of this stuff you can definitely see how this turned into the final concept, you know, back in the back. And then we kind of went to a visor that was super simple, that really didn't have any other vents in it or anything, which is actually what we ended up settling on too. Just kind of be closer to the design. The one thing you can't really see with these graphics on are the small details that are on here. I don't think I have, oh, I do actually. So this is, you can kind of see this is like early proto, this is actually a kid's helmet now. So this one is, that one's an adult, the one that I showed you. You can kind of see some of the detailing on there. And it's got this flat spot right here. And what that flat spot is for is GoPro cameras. So that, because a lot of people want to mount their cameras on their helmets now. So we created this, originally we didn't have it there, and as we went along we figured out that we wanted to put that on there. And so we, and then literally on the graphic we included it, it says H.264, you know, digital, like digital film type setting. So, I wish I still did autocross so I could get one. Yeah, that would be awesome. The thing is, I could probably send you one too. what else? Oh wow, there's a coal pattern. Oh, you mean in the mouth? Do you consider which pattern would help with airflow? Yeah, actually we do. Basically how this, I mean, it's pretty basic to be honest with you. It's, when you're working on a helmet, basically it's a ball. And so you want air coming in from the front. And so what that does is it travels over the head and forces air in. But actually what happens in the back is you have heat coming off of your head, and actually the heat will go out of the exhaust. So what the fresh air come in does, it forces that hot air out. So it's not actually, it's like a pressure type thing. So this is causing high pressure to come in the front, and that forces the hot air out the back is what it's doing. So it's not like you're, like you would think that the air, I mean, it is flowing through, but it's not like it's just flowing freely through there. It's creating a lot of pressure. It gets built up in here, like the cool air. And what that does is it forces the hot air out eventually is what it's doing. And so any of your back vents, like here and here, all this stuff is gonna be hot air flowing out. And then anything in the front, like all of this stuff, and even this, we ended up putting vents in like right up here, like these right here. That will, it's got air coming in, like your, like this visor will actually act like an air duct and blow that right into those holes. So it creates like this ram air induction into the helmet. It's pretty cool. So these are just several iterations of working on that. I kind of like the feel of this. This was kind of different, but again, we felt it got a little too much going on. So we wanted to start simplifying it. Wow, a lot of these are, I think some of these are just the same. Anyways, this ended up being the final rendering for the helmet. And then almost Stormtrooper from Star Wars. I like the ones that ride the speeders on the tree planet. Yeah. Ever thought of changing the plating panels on the visor? Like more serpentine or art deco sort of curves. Yeah, right now, basically a lot of the styling in the motocross industry is a lot more squared off. Dionysi, a lot of European companies do a lot of more of the rounded off stuff. But in North America, it tends to be more of squared off stuff right now and very clean and simple. Drawing out a Steven Universe. The helmet can fart. Yes, exactly. Oh, thanks, Chad. So anyways, from this point, from what you're looking at now, this is where it gets really crazy. So it goes into... Oh, this thing's a bit heavy, but... This is, see if I can make sure you guys can see this. So this ends up being the clay that I built out of that design. Let's get that all. This is very barbaric the way this is all put together because it doesn't have to be clean. So from that model or from that design, I start to sculpt it in clay. So that became the, and I only sculpted one side. So because the base of it is actually another helmet. So I shaved it all down and carved it all out. And then we actually submit this, kind of like they do in video games, you know, like the tracking humans and stuff. They'll actually take this in the 3D and scan it all in. Oh man, I messed up some of the surfacing on here. Oh well. So this was the visor. So I had that attached up there too, like that. But so what they do is they scan this all in, and then they clean up all the surfaces because I don't get them exactly perfect. And then like if you look on the other side here, you can see how rough that is still. Like I don't even finish it on that side because it's not even needed. The only reason I might use the other side sometimes is if we try a different concept. So that's basically the process. And then from there, it goes to 3D, and it goes to the factory, and we're getting it produced in Taiwan. So they take all that information and then start making the product. And then this is the final deal. So it's a pretty cool process, but you can see why it takes a long time to do. It's a lot of work. Oh, the helmet I borrow by Auto X Autocross makes me look like I'm mentally handicapped. Oh, bummer. So you don't autocross anymore? Oh, thanks, Elaine. Hey, what's up, Earthmuck? I said hi to you earlier, but maybe you were just lurking then. Yeah, I was just kind of showing and telling the... This is the helmet that I've been working on for like a year and a half, Earthmuck. This is the industry I work in, and this is like the stuff that I do a lot of. So, and then I also, another helmet, let's see, so you do this in 3D right off the bat instead of clay? No, I did the clay first. Yeah, I learned this from the auto industry. I worked in the, like, I went to school for car design, so, even the auto industry starts out in clay. Now, and they don't really, and then they actually scan it in just like that. They don't go straight to 3D most of the time. So, oh, you couldn't. Oh, thanks, not an artist. But just to show you guys, let's see. I also got to work on another helmet. Now this one here, I did not, this is not my entire design. I just worked on some of it. I kind of came in the middle of the project and made a bunch of comments and worked on like interior stuff and some of the graphic stuff. So this is actually a mountain bike helmet here. But I don't have one of these on me right now. So this is the final product here. Now this helmet, like that last helmet that I showed you guys, is actually what they call a polycarbonate plastic. So this is a plastic helmet. That's actually injection molded. So it's like it's made out of steel molds, and then they inject plastic into it. And then this one here that you're seeing on the screen, this is actually a carbon fiber. So it's laid up in sheets of like fiberglass. I don't know if any of you mess with fiberglass, but it's like put down in sheets, and then there's a resin that puts on it, and then it's like formed basically. So the retail price, actually this one's like really nice. This is like $109. So this is considered like an entry level price point, but it's like, this is a pretty trick helmet for $109. It's got a lot of real kind of like a more mid-tier type treatment to it. Now it does have a basic interior, but it's got like a lot of the custom stuff. Like if you find most helmets, like this trim is all custom done, and a lot of the helmets, it's just a rubber piece that goes on there that's like a stock material. And so all of this is like custom done, so it has more of a trick look to it. There we go, now you can see it. And then like the rivets here on the side, those are all custom done. Custom color mouthpiece, a lot of times these are only black on entry level stuff. And then this helmet here, I don't remember the retail on it. I want to say it's like $350 to $400 because it's carbon. So this is like, this helmet here is more like top of the line mountain bike helmet. Like, you know, like if you see these pictures, it's a lot of, you know, more aggressive riding like this. So, and this is actually, I do mountain biking, but probably not quite this aggressive. I'm not that gung-ho. Like my friend was telling me that he went here when this helmet launched, and he said that there was this section of the track that had this bridge built across it, but then it had a big old gap, and you jumped this like big old fire road. And he said it was pretty crazy. But yeah, I don't do that extreme of writing, but I do you know, enough. It's pretty fun. So that's pretty much my show and tell time. I was excited to show you guys that. So it's already 10:37. I can't wait to hear how he got in the con. You're gonna watch the interview. Yeah. How he got into concept design. He doesn't really talk too much about that. You should click the YT thing I linked earlier. Oh, what'd you link? I don't think I saw that, Elaine. Oh, hey, thanks for the follow, by the way. Appreciate that. Let's see, where's your link? Oh, who steals the shot from the white car? Oh, that's funny. Is that you? Is that you in the white, in the black car? No, I didn't see that interview with Craig Mullins with Level Up. Oh, that is you. Oh, that's funny. That's awesome. Where is that? I want to see that again. Actually, I always wanted to get into autocross. I love that stuff. I'm a big car guy. That's awesome. That's cool. Oh, after the Bobby Chu interview. Okay. All right. So, so the other thing I was going to work on tonight, I'll start doing this while I'm talking to all you guys. I'm going to start doing some spaceship designs for my space race thing. So, oh, is this the other one for, oh, okay, cool. Oh, what was I trying to explain, Earthmuck? I don't remember. Actually, I'm going to steal your link, and I'm going to put that in our Discord. Let's see here. Resources, there we go. Awesome, I'm going to have to go back and watch that. I'm all ears and eyes for this, right on. I'm gonna pull up my images here. Oh wait, wrong folder. Kind of forgot where I stuck that stuff. I'm looking for my spaceships that I did. Actually, I really don't need them, to be truthfully honest with you. Oh, do this all day, every day. I try, man. You know, with having a full-time job and doing this in the evenings, and then I've got four kids and then my wife, and it's a bit challenging, but I love streaming because actually I got on here originally because of my card deck, because I wanted to really just promote that on, like, so that people could see me draw that stuff live and to promote the card deck. The one thing I didn't talk about, the final finished product, is when it's finally done, actually all the proceeds are going to a charity that I support, and it's called Redeeming Love, and they're basically making a house and training for women that come out of the sex slave trade. So, like, you know, people that have, I know that this has become a hot topic out there with all the, you know, this being exposed and stuff. So anyways, they're making a house for, like, a safe house for the women to go to and get training and to basically, you know, help them to get jobs and get into the real world again. So it's a cool cause and it's a fun project I'm working on. So it's going to all go to that. Oh, jeez. Oh, the perspective. Oh, in the books, that could help. Yeah, no problem, Murph Muck. Do I have the... I put it away. What's Pooh saying here? Him and his burning car and birds. So do you stream, Elaine? See, I can barely handle the cat. Right, man. it's funny. You've got that poos bird. I'm gonna have to make a chicken icon sometime. I'm gonna attack helicopter. All right, Chad. Take care, man. Oh yeah, so you work all the time too. Yeah, I mean, the nice thing is about my job is that they are based in Idaho, and I get to actually work from home. So, like, that's why I have, like, all my clay work here and everything. It's all just in my garage and stuff. So. So this is what I'm gonna work on. Right now, I'm going to show you guys. I think a lot of you saw this. I'm going to go back to my artwork setup here. So these are thumbnails. And actually, you'd probably dig this, Elaine. So I'm working on this storyline, and it's called The Great Space Race. And it's all... it's all inspired by automotive styling, but it's a race that takes place in space, obviously, hence the name. But it's NASA loses all government funding, and basically they go out and seek corporate funding, and they want to basically reinvigorate the whole space program, which is sort of what's kind of really happening in the real world right now. And so I drew these earlier spaceships. Maybe I should bring this stuff up. And they're all based on like American culture, and then I did another one that was kind of based on Italian styling and then British styling. Like I used cues from like Austin Martin and stuff like that. And I'm gonna bring up my art station real quick. And I'll bring it over here. My profile. So it's these ships right here. Oh, whoops, you can't see that stuff. I gotta go back to my desktop. So this was the British Space Racer. And so I did these a few years back, actually 2012, you can see the date. But I want to continue this storyline, and I want to do characters and environments and just kind of continue the whole thing of making these spaceships out of car styling. But you can kind of see the scale of it, like the cockpit's really tiny and these are like big, big spaceships. And so they would sit on something like they're launched into space like the space shuttle is. You can kind of see the scale right here to next to this human. And so that thumbnail that you were looking at there is actually a Japanese version now. So I'm taking like different cues like from drift cars and I don't know what they call that other weird thing that's going on. Oh, thanks, Humble Peanut. I appreciate that. But have you seen that stuff like in Japan where they got these big old wings, you know, sticking out and big old pipes and stuff like that? I have no idea what they call that styling, but it's super bizarre. In fact, personally, I think a lot of it's ugly, but I thought some of this stuff would be really cool to throw in there and incorporate. So, but you'll see a lot of the engine components like intercoolers and other things that you would see sticking out of, you know, drift cars and things like that. I'll probably rip off, you know, some of the stuff, and you'll see some of the, you know, like they'll rip off their bumpers and stuff like that, you know, after drifting. So I want to show some of the parts underneath there and stuff. So these sketches were based on that, kind of taking some of that styling and applying it to that same feeling of the car racing thing. So let's see. Oh, thanks. Oh, Poos is lurking. Art of DHT. Gender fluidity? Or non-binary people? Hey, Ryan, how you doing, man? Good to see you pop in here. And then the other thing that I worked on too was these were the small thumbnails that I did based on, so this is using that ink, and then I used a water brush and I brushed over the ink so it like smeared it all over, and then I used a little bit of white gouache and hit it with some orange pencil. Really, really fun and fast technique. Like, and so to explain this, like these are mostly made for myself, so I understand what's going on here. So this would be the launch pad sticking up, and then the ship is sitting on there. So the light's kind of draping across it. This is more of like looking down on top of it. So you see like the launch pad and all that other stuff in the background. This one here was a variation where it would be like you'd have all the launch pads next to each other. So, and I'm going to continue and keep doing this. So I'll do this on another stream, kind of show some of that. Let's see. Oh, thanks, Ryan. I appreciate that, man. That top one reminds me of Cylon Craft Reboot. Earthmuck, which one are you talking about? I'm not sure. I don't remember that. And I appreciate your comment too, Humble Peanut. That reminds me of Bosozuko stuff? I don't think I'm familiar with that. I don't think, at least. I gotta look that one up. Man, I haven't really got to draw tonight yet. Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's totally it. It's exactly what I'm talking about. So they call that Bosozoku style. Bosozoku. That's funny. Thanks for the heads up on that. That's great stuff. Camaro to a Camaro. Oh, okay. Oh, you think... Oh, I could see that. I could see that right there, for sure. Man, tonight I spent most of my time talking. It's a pretty major thing. Japan can do anything like... Can't do anything like normal people. We could be seeing sketches of a future movie. Yeah, I mean, it would be cool if somebody wanted the idea, but in all honesty, who knows? I mean, I'm going to basically run it like that. Like, all this concept work is going to be as if a director came to me and said, here's the scenario, this is what I want all this done for. So this is kind of, I wanted something to really fill my time on the second part of my stream most of the time. So I wanted to, like, the card deck takes the first part, and then this will be the second part now. And I wanted to really push myself to do more character and more environment stuff. So that's what this is going to do. It's going to give me a basis on a reason why to do that stuff, you know? Now. And I'll have reasons to do characters instead of just drawing random characters and stuff like that. I'll have a reason on why I'm designing a character. And like, I think that's another important thing to do when you're designing things, is if you give yourself a reason or a story to go by, you can, I think you can think better. And I think it gives you a purpose to draw something instead of just trying to draw something cool out of this, you know, straight out of your head. If you think of a purpose or story, then it kind of makes sense. And I think it inspires you more too. Like, you don't get sick of something. So right now I'm just going to draw like super quick, almost like idea generator stuff for myself. Oh, thanks, Dragon Lord. I am too. I hope I can pull it off, man. Character stuff. Although, I feel like I've been getting way better at it just because of... because I've been studying a lot more. What happened there? Wait, oh, man. Stuff got moved around. Dang it. You're afflicted with the same condition. You know, I think artists are like that in general. Like, you start to get into something and you just go full bore. I know I am. I know my wife has talked to me about that before. She's like, man, when you get into something, you just go crazy with it. And I'm like, yeah, I do. That's definitely me. Like, I gotta be really careful with what I get into, because if I get into something, it's like, yeah, I really get into it. I'm trying to get my right brush here. Actually, to be honest with you, I'm gonna lose this. I'm gonna ditch this thing right now. Yeah, what I was using, somebody mentioned the Camaro on there about looking sort of like that. I was actually looking at the front ends of, you know, dots, old dots and Zs. So usually, like, I like to draw like the typical stuff at first, and then usually my stuff will start to evolve into stuff that's a little more creative, I think. And I think that's something that we all suffer from at first, like we draw the typical. What are you guys saying here? Ryan, you know, man, in all honesty, it's talent is an interesting thing, too. I know that Poos talks about this. I really do believe that I personally don't think I'm talented, in all honesty. I think I've been the type of person that, you know, like they're mentioning that once you grab onto something, you don't want to let go. It's like I guess I would call my drive a tenacity of a bulldog, you know. Bulldogs were bred to take down a bull and they grab onto their throat. I know this is probably not the best example, but that's what they were bred for, and I think I'm that type of person, because when I was at Art Center, I was by far not one of the strongest students, but I think I worked myself up to that because, you know, I looked at my competition, and I'm like, I want to be that good, and I want to be better than them, you know, and I think I've just always had that drive. Even now, like, I feel like I still need so much work to be, you know, I want to become one of those designers or artists that are, you know, I want to become the status of like an Eric Timmons or a, you know, Craig Mullins. I want to be that caliber of artist, you know, that you can tell that they're well studied and they're masters at what they do, you know. It's because they put in tons and tons of hard work, and I really think that anybody that puts in hard work can trump someone that might have, you know, say an inclination that might do better than them at a certain thing, you know. I think we all have the capability of becoming amazing, actually, you know, is basically how I'd put it. And I kind of want, you know, and I know I have tons of room to hit that status, to become like an amazing artist, but I desire that and I want to achieve that, you know. But, you know, and I've been doing this since I could pick up a pencil. My parents have drawings in my closets from... Oh, I lost all my music. Let's go to this here. To your favorite car, C3s are insane. Yeah, I agree with you, man. Oh yeah, you guys are old school Israel. What's up, man? Let's do this just to have something up. I'm gonna take a look at this, see how I have some of these proportions and stuff going. Oh man, it's already 11:02. Unfortunately, guys, I've probably only got a few more minutes tonight. I didn't get as far as I wanted to on this stuff. Let's see, I'm going way back. I'll just... Humble Peanut. Yeah, I love 240Zs. Love them. Have you guys ever seen the Toyota... Oh my gosh, it just left my head. What's the name of that Toyota that looks like a Ferrari? Fair Lady? Is that the Fair Lady? Might be the Fair Lady. I don't know, but it's worth millions of dollars. 203 there. Right on, Ryan. I need to load up some of my... I forgot that I have these inspiration images that I wanted to use. On my Pinterest, I have a huge JDM folder that's got all kinds of cool stuff in it. Let's see here. Yeah, there's a lot of sick Japanese cars that I love, man. I like the 240s for sure. The old Skylines. Oh my gosh, the old Skylines. There's old Mazdas. I love all those. The Datsun 510s. Oh man, I'd love to have any of those. The 510 wagons, I love those things too, man. Those are sick. I've even seen some of those the old Toyota pickups fixed up too. Or no, I'm sorry, the Datsun pickups. Those are super cool as well. Oh yeah, 2000 GT. There you go. That's it. That's what I was trying to think of. That would be the one. Man, I appreciate all you guys coming by tonight. That was, I had a really good turnout tonight, man. Had some pretty awesome and talented streamers in the stream tonight, which is cool. And thank you, Elaine, for stopping by too. I appreciate that as well. It was kind of you. Late 90s Imprezas. Yeah, look nice. Supras, yeah, oh my gosh, some of the old Supras too. I love those. I love the, what was it, like 98? Isn't that when it was kind of like really hot? I want to do something different than this typical fin here. I want to do something like What could I use for this? Old Toyota Celicas are cool too. I think I might just, let's see what can I have. Actually, I don't know. A lot of you people may not know, but I have a Subaru WRX, like an 04. That car's sweet. I love that thing, man. It's a lot of fun. Oh yeah, Monday night car shows. Oh, what do you? Oh, I see what you're looking at here. Oh, Prowler. You like the Prowlers? One of the new Plymouths. Humble, it's actually, it's the WRX. It's not the STI version, unfortunately. It's the wagon, though. I got the wagon. I really wanted a wagon, kind of with having a family and stuff. And it's super fun, man. I can still fit a lot of kids in it, or a decent amount, I should say. I still can't fit my whole family in it. But yeah, it's an 04 wagon. I got it off this old Japanese guy. I think the funny thing was, though, it needed a decent amount of tuning up, and I think he was actually putting regular gas in it, so it, like, gummed up a lot of the system. So, like, when I originally drove it, it was so sluggish. I was like, dude, this thing doesn't drive very well. I was almost reluctant to buy it. But then I started figuring out that I think it just needed a little TLC. Sure enough, that's what it was. I kind of like the proportion on this one down here. Side view looks great, actually. Let's put that up there, I guess, now. You guys talking about here? Oh, I didn't look at this Monday night car show thing. Oh yeah, the Prowler. Yeah, saw that. Okay. The only connection I have to any kind of rally cars is filming a TV ad for an old workplace. That's cool. I was thinking maybe add a spike at the back of the fin going backwards. Yeah, that could work. Anyway, my time's up. See y'all later. Oh, okay. Take care, Earthmuck. Have a good night, man. Monsieur's here. How you doing? Dropping in for 15 minutes. Oh, cool. I'm probably gonna get off here in a little bit, Monsieur, anyway. So, yeah, my trip to Taiwan was really good. I actually got to show... Here, in fact, this is why I was in Taiwan, was because of this. This is what I've been working on for the last year and a half. So it's final production helmet. So it came out. So I did the full design of the helmet and then also the graphics on this one. so. But that's why I was in Taiwan. Came out pretty nice. Oops, I just took away my reference. Where'd I put my reference at? Did I just close it out? Dang it. I did. What are you saying, Monsieur? Oh, you love the front. Oh, thanks, man. Did I model it? No. Actually, yeah, I got to. If you go back in my VOD later on, Humble, I showed the whole process that I went through to do that. I went from sketches into clay model, then 3D, and then to final production. So if you want to check it out, go back and if you're interested in that, and go back and watch it, and I show everything that I did. What if I went more like looking at some of this dots and styling too? So some of this styling too is going to be, heavily, like on the Japanese ones. I love drift racing a lot, man, so I'll definitely use a lot of that as inspiration. So I probably won't get super far tonight. I'm going to have to call it a night just because I got to get up in the morning and... I don't know if I'm meeting somebody in the morning or not. I might be waking up at 5:30 a.m., so I need to probably call it a night here soon, guys. Is this stream or overtime? Normally, let's see, oh wait, let's see. Digimon, I already said that. An aerial atom ship would be awesome. Like a ship with a pressurized cabin, just strap the pilot in a spacesuit. That's pretty cool, Ghost. I like that. That might be really, really interesting. Yeah, so this would be like a torn down thing and you'd have this like tiny roll cage or something like that that they would be sitting in. Yeah. That would be pretty cool. I kind of like some of that. Is this a stream or overtime? I usually get off between... Normally my stream time is like 9 to 11 is what I try to do, but I've had to start later because of just timing issues and just doing a bunch of family stuff, basically. So I've had to start at 9:30, so I usually try to stay on a little bit later right now. But I do have my full-time job in the morning, so I can't like stay on super late most of the time. Some of the times I do stay on late, though, is I'll... my wife is a nurse, so she'll work a lot of times on the weekends. So like on Friday evenings, I'll stay on. I think I've stayed on till like 2 a.m. then, so... But my normal stream times are Tuesday, Thursday... from 9 to 11, and then I always get in like a third stream somewhere in during the week. So let's see, what else can I do here? Really like it any of these yet. Oh, where did I attend college? I went to Art Center in Pasadena. Actually studied transportation design there. And then, did you show the helmet process in just this stream? Oh, yes, only in this stream. So when this stream is over with, you can go back and watch it. So, yeah, because this is the first time I was able to show that, because that's all under confidential stuff, you know? So I haven't shown any of that I've been working on the whole year until tonight. So everyone in my stream, that was kind of their first time to see it. I don't really like the feel of this drop-down thing back here. I like that roll cage idea. I'm going to play with that eventually. I'm trying to get a feel of, I really don't know what the feeling of these rear will look like. Like, I don't want it too car-like. Saw the person throwing in the show scale, man, that's a big ship. Yeah, that's the idea behind it. I still want it to have a huge spaceship feel to it, but have very car-centric styling to it, you know? So I'm not super concerned about my perspective and stuff right now, because I'm just going for generating a ton of ideas right now for the ship. Like I said, most of this stuff I'm not loving yet, so my feeling isn't there yet. I just think I'm drawing a lot of typical stuff right now. get the funky beats going. Let's go. Hey, Monsieur, that's my life every day, man. I love it. Kids are awesome, man. I think my kids keep me young. They keep me from feeling like an old man. I think they really spark my imagination a lot of times as well. In fact, they absolutely love this spaceship idea. One of my sons has actually given me several good ideas. It's fun. See, you could put some fins on the underside like a hydrofoil. Yeah, that's a good idea. I like that, Christmas. Dude, what song is this? This is cool. Shades of Funk, Kill Paris. I hope this is a non-licensed song. I gotta hear it again, guys. Hope you don't mind. So what are you saying here, NA Artist? If you had a light source behind it and it was floating in the air, where would the shadow start? If you had a light source behind it, so you're saying like back here? Or something like where the engines are all lit up back here or something? I mean, because really, you know, you figure if one of these big ships is outside, it's going to be, you know, you're going to get tons of lighting sources. You know, you're going to get, well, obviously you're going to get the sun, and then you're going to have like, then you're going to have the clouds in the air that are bouncing light all over the place. Then you have, you know, like what are its surroundings? Is it around like mountains or something like that? You know, you got, so really, like when you're dealing with huge like objects like this that you can put outside, you can bounce light around all over the place, and you could put shadows all over, you know. And then if you're talking about where the setting of the sun is, you know, if you're saying that it's behind it, I mean, if you just wanted to light it with a light source, I mean, you could run the shadow, you know, kick it out in front of the actual object like that. And it also depends on how low it is to the ground. So you would, well, if it's really coming behind it, I really want the light source coming this way. So you just drop it on the ground, and then depending on how high it is, you know, this shadow is going to get moved down accordingly, if that's kind of what you're asking. When I get ready to do renderings and do that stuff, I'll talk more about it and kind of work on the lighting and all that stuff, and I'll explain a lot of that. Right now I'm just concepting it, you know, coming up with ideas and not really giving much of that stuff a thought yet about lighting and all that. I like that hydrofoil idea, but let's see. Maybe it goes under like that. It doesn't read really well like that, though. Oh, let's see, I lost my that structure kind of look like? I shouldn't have drawn my line drawing right over the top of my roughs because I because now when I erase I lose my stuff. Hey Lancelot, how you doing? Good seeing you here. Let's see. Oh, would it spread out? It would only spread out if it was super high in the air, basically. You know, because what you're doing is if you take a light, like take a light sometime, and if you hold your hand up, if you as you get closer to the light, it'll spread that shadow out more. And it's basically the same thing as like when you have an airplane in the air, the closer it is to the sun, the more that shadow gets spread out. And so and you can do that example basically with a light in front of you. And it also becomes a lot more faint too. It becomes more fuzzy around the edges. Yeah, I'm doing good, Lancelot. And the pilots wouldn't be navigating purely on visuals. Yeah, absolutely, Ghost. And I'll probably have something on that. Because I was thinking about, you know, what would the cockpits look like inside these ships, you know? I am not liking this back end area at all, so I'm gonna erase some of that. Guess what I did on this one is I actually just cut it off so it just kind of tapered down. Then I had all the like mechanical stuff coming out the back. So when you're in the concepting phase, it's really important that you just stay super, super loose. Don't get tight with your drawings yet. I think that's because what happens when you start getting tighter with your drawings, you don't allow those what I call happy accidents happen, where you might pick up a shape or something like that that you like. And so this gives me a good enough idea of what I'm kind of going for. But I'm gonna definitely do, I'm gonna do a ton of ideas on this. I could start to even add some value and shape. Like, I really like what's going on right here. I like all this stuff sticking out. Still iffy about this back here. I love Ghost's idea of doing that like the guy's actually just strapped in there and it's like total open cockpit, like it's all stripped down. I like that idea, but I don't know what that cockpit's gonna look like yet, you know? Alright guys, I do need to call it tonight. As I keep drawing. Yeah, so now I'd probably just leave that as it is and I'll go up and explore this one now. But so let's see, today is Thursday. I'll be streaming tomorrow night again, guys. I'm gonna continue with this. I'm gonna see if I can get some more thumbnails done tomorrow at my lunch on this specific thing and try to get some ideas cranked out, because I actually told Dragon I'd try to do some rendering stuff tomorrow night. So if anything, it might be a little bit looser than this. I might just take a couple of these and render them up really fast in Photoshop. So I'm gonna try to get some more thumbnails done at lunchtime tomorrow. I'll see if I get anything I like, and then we'll go from there. And I will be streaming actually on Monday night probably too. So Tuesday, Thursday this week, and Friday tomorrow night, and then Monday night, and then Tuesday night again. So and most of the time, I think right now with the way my schedule is, I'm gonna have to start streaming at 9:30 just for now. If I can hop on earlier, I will. I'll try to get on get on close to 9. So somewhere in the neighborhood between 9 and 9:30. Right now, with my schedule being so busy, it's a little more up in the air. But when all this is over with, I'll be able to do closer to 9 o'clock. But that won't be till like maybe December. And then the other thing is, I am going on vacation. I'm gonna do a road trip with the family here on, let's see, I leave on the 11th. Holy cow. No, wait. Yeah, the 11th through the 25th. So I'm gonna be gone for like almost 2 weeks, guys. But I'll try to knock out several before I leave. And then after I get back on the 25th, it'll be pretty much solid streaming for a while. So just letting you guys know. So if you wonder where I'm at, I'm not just disappearing, just taking a break, taking some vacation. But if you guys don't follow me on Instagram, I'll still be posting stuff on Instagram. I'll take, no, Lancelot, it's not Friday yet for me. It's actually a Thursday. You must be overseas. So yeah, if you don't follow me on Instagram, follow me on there, because I'm gonna take my sketchbook with me, because I'm actually going to Wyoming, and we're gonna go in the Grand Tetons and see all that stuff. Let's see, I think, let me bring up all my stuff for you. I think this is my, let's see, social. Yep, there it is. There's everything, guys. So Instagram, I update, and so my Instagram will automatically update my Twitter and my Facebook. Do I even have my Facebook on there? Whoa, I don't. Oh, it's kind of dumb. Oh well. You'll miss my stream again. I'm sorry, Lancelot. Yeah, just come around when you can. I know that you can't make it all the time. It's all good. I get it. I can't make everybody stream all the time either, so. So anyways, I'll be posting artwork. I'll probably try to draw some stuff like, this is what I really want to do on my trip. I want to do, these studies. I'm going to try to do more of these studies like this. Let's see. Gotta see my camera. Where is it? There it is. So I want to do some studies like this, just really quick compositional type stuff. Hopefully in the mountains and stuff, I'll get to do that. I know my kids like to draw with me too, so we'll probably be hopefully doing that together while I'm gone on vacation. So I will post that stuff on Instagram while I'm doing that. So thanks for coming into the stream, and thanks for... I want to say thank you to all my mods again. Thank you very, very much. And thanks again, Dragon Lord. She got her new promotion last week. So. Oh, forgetting your stream, I need to sleep, or your stream at night. Oh, I see. I'm sorry. So I'm going to go ahead and look for somebody to raid tonight. Let's see who's on. Yeah, thanks for, and sorry, I don't know if Not an Artist is still here. Apologize for all that. Getting all messed up tonight. Let's see here. Following. Let's see who's on. Hey, they're playing Magic. I haven't played that in a while. Oh, John Lee Studios on, Monsters, Russell R. Jones. I've raided a lot of these people. We could raid Adobe. Let's see. Gosh, these guys have like tons of people in there though, so. Let's just go to, gosh, that's crazy. There's like nobody on that I follow right now. Let's see here. I'm gonna go to Twitch Creative. You know, the way they've got the new menu and everything, I never know if I'm, like, finding people. Let's see here. What the heck? Well, there we go. Oh, you know what? I'm going to send you guys to... Do you guys... I'm going to send you to Two Senseless. Some of you might know who she is already. She does some stuff on Adobe. I've never raided her. She draws a lot of traditional stuff. She's doing some... Oh, wait a minute. Is she getting off right now? I don't know if she is. Actually, you know what? Nah, it doesn't look like she's doing something else now. Dang it. Does anybody have any recommendations right now? Chicken, you are my mech inspiration. Oh, I didn't see that. That's thanks, Lancelot. I appreciate that, man. For more mech. Some Mexican sombreros, yeah. Raider, so she stays on. I thought I followed her. That's strange. This is always my dilemma, man. All right, I'm gonna pick somebody here. Let's see. All right, I'll go ahead. I'm gonna see what she's doing again real quick. Yeah, see what I'm saying? All right. Yeah, I know. I saw John Lee was on Samantha. You'll be on in a couple of hours. Well, yeah, that doesn't do me any good, Cross. I would totally send everybody your way, man. All right. Well, we could raid Adobe just for the heck of it. Although I think they're getting off at midnight, right? All right, I'll send you to John Lee Studio. I'm going to just do it. All right, here's the link. And you can go in and say Chicken Raid or whatever you guys want. Go crazy with Chicken Raid. Yeah, oh, hey, there's Sam. He comes out of the woodwork. All right, yeah, I'm going to send you guys to John Lee Studio. So... I will talk to all you guys tomorrow night. I'll be streaming tomorrow night, guys. So hopefully I will see you there. And I'll be able to do a longer stream tomorrow as well. So I will talk to you guys later. Have a good night, y'all.